fang, freddo, carne. It's still cold as a dog out there here in Paris, France. This is the central core of Swiss chard. And the little critters are sprouting up there. I wonder if I could root this. I guess I could put this in one of my planters or something and see what happens with it. This, you know, what happens with me is when my spouse goes out to do our shopping, whatever he can find a good price on is what we end up with. And he brings it back. He does ask me for some feedback. I've encouraged him to do that. But basically, I just kind of have to figure out what to do with whatever he brings back, whether it's meat, produce, you know, all kinds of stuff. And this is a single Swiss chard, and these are called blette here in France, and they're very easy to grow. I gave some seeds to my relatives out in Brittany, and they grew very readily with no help whatsoever. I'm going to be spending some time cleaning these. I love when I see vegetables which are very dirty. You know, I don't really want clean, highly processed things, and if there are critters in them, you know, so much the better. It's probably an indication of goodness. So I'm going to be spending some time turning these around, upside down and everything, and getting grit off of them. And I've just been looking through some old cookbooks, and I cannot recommend old cookbooks highly enough. They're easy to get at yard sales, and they're just a really terrific point of reference for me. I have a lot of cooking experience, but I forget stuff. And even when you move from country to country and foods are different and the altitude is different and the water is different and the source of heat is different, you can still get some pointers from old cookbooks. And there's a lot of good stuff on the internet also, but I really like the print media a great deal. And I remember I made a sweet and sour chard dish a while back that came out well. These are nice with pork frequently. We might have pork for dinner tonight. I should set some out and thaw it. But this is quite a bit, and I've got to figure out how to prepare it, and probably it's going to be blanched and braised. And I also see an interesting recipe in an old James Beard cookbook about how to make a baked dish with this, where you start it off on its own and you finish off by adding a few eggs to it. But it has to be ground up. Pretty fun, you know? This is very, very healthy stuff, and the flavor is not extremely strong. I'm going to be taking some time to clean this. You don't want grit on things. It's not good for you. It's like eating glass, basically, and it's unpleasant. So I'm going to be turning it around in this water for about an hour. And a lot of things you can't soak for a long period of time, but some things you can for an hour or so. So once I get this cleaned up, this ought to be right fun to play with. And once things are blanched, you know, you can cool them down and chop them up and freeze them. They'll keep for quite a while like that, as long as you got electricity. It'll be fun to figure out what I can do with this. It looks like it's growing. It might root. I guess I could set it out in a planter. All right, see.